68-yard field goal. The 68-yard field goal. I can't. Come on. If you make this, JT.
What? 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 He made that. I thought he missed it. What? He made that. Oh, he made it. Oh. JT. JT. Did he really make that? Oh, because it went to the back of the crossbar. This dude, he made a 66 yard field goal. He made a 66 yard field goal. He made a 66 yard field. What?
Yeah, this feels like a dream. And you know just what I mean. You see my boy, he like gotta made it, gotta made it. Boy, he's a fan and he like the Ravens, like the Ravens. And you know just what I mean. You two team, keep it clean. You see my boy, he like gotta made it.
There's that cheesy saying, even though it's still true, that in certain moments you never forget where you were when it happened. So that certainly applies to Justin Tucker hitting that 66-yard, not only a 66-yard field goal, but a 66-yard game-winning field goal. And it, of course, broke the record, or set the new record, to longest field goal in NFL history. And Justin Tucker has been just that, a historic kicker. Before we get into this video, YouTube team, keep it clean. What's going on? I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. The game against the Lions was crazy. The game against the Lions was stressful. But this is not, we'll talk about the game later on today. But this kick and everything that was involved with it was just, it was epic, man. It was epic. And there has never, ever been anything like this before. Because again, it's a new record. It's a new record. And just to take you through what I was going through during that kick, and I'm sure a lot of y'all can relate too. So we get in position to kick a field goal, and I'm thinking, oh, what? They're going for it. Initially, I thought it was like a 58-yarder. So a little more of a realistic kick. But then when they said a 66-yard field goal, I was like, whoa. Like, I love Justin Tucker. We all love him and appreciate him. He's been doing this thing ever since his rookie year. Undrafted free agent kicker that the Ravens signed out of Texas. He was in competition with Billy Cundiff, who the previous year just gave Ravens fans, and it wasn't all his fault, obviously, because if they play better defense and if they play better offense, they would have scored more points. If they play better defense, then the Patriots would have scored less points. But Billy Cundiff, that was, as a Ravens fan, that was the most heartbreaking loss ever. Ever. When he missed that field goal kick that would have sent the game into overtime. Oh, that thing was painful. But it led to the following year, the Ravens allowing Justin Tucker to compete with him for the job at kicker. And it took a lot of guts by the Ravens to go with a young, undrafted guy, obviously no NFL experience, over the veteran at the kicking position. So they went with him, and it was history since. They obviously won the Super Bowl his rookie year, and he has just been kicking his way throughout the record books for the entirety of his career. Always been an amazing kicker. And something that we talked about yesterday with Justin Tucker is that we, since he's been so great, we hold him to this high standard, and we expect greatness from him. We expect him to just make every kick. And even when he misses, it's so weird, man. It's always so weird when Justin Tucker actually misses a kick, because we're not used to that. But every single time, we always, it's okay. He gets a pass. Because we're not used to him being somebody that ends up coming up short. But right here on this 66-yard field goal, I was thinking, oh, well, 66. I want him to make it. And I know he got a foot, you're inside a dome, yeah, but 66-yard field goals, like, ooh, that's something right there. And when the ball went up, it looked like it was in good position as far as going down the middle, but live when I was watching, it just looked like it was short. And I was looking like, it's not going to make it all the way. And then when it hit the crossbar, I was like, man, I said, I can't even be mad at him though, man. Can't even be mad at him. This is everything that was going on in my head, because I'm like, yeah, and he did miss the field goal earlier too. So again, there were so many different things that contributed to this game and the reason why the game was in the shape that it was in for the Ravens. And they could have put it away a long time ago, but a lot of miscues, obviously the drops and just poor tackling. It's just a mix of so many things. And we'll talk about all that later. But I was thinking, oh man, it's short. So the ball hit the crossbar, and then in the broadcast, you see it hit the crossbar and just go up and then go down. I was thinking, well, looks like we just lost to the Lions. Shout out to the Lions. They were 0-2. Now they 1-2, and we go to 1-2. Not a good look, but it's not the end of the world. It's not the end of the season. It's still early. And Ravens, they lose a close one, and they a lot of issues that they could have taken care of earlier, but it just we lost to the Lions. But then I saw the refs slowly, and they just knew they had our hearts. They knew they had all of our hearts in their hands. Both Lions' hearts and Ravens fans' hearts were in their hands. And they slowly went like this, and I couldn't believe it. I really couldn't believe it, because I'm like, how? How is this happening? What just happened? He made it? I thought he missed. And I was just like, wow. So then they showed the replay, and they showed it from the angle to where you could see the football hit the back of the crossbar and then go to the back of the field goal pole. And I was, oh, okay, he did make it. And there were obviously no complaints for me, but it was just very, very emotional. And it was just because it's just crazy. And the Ravens, this is what they've been doing these past 3 weeks. This is what they've been doing these past 3 weeks. They just been taking us for these crazy rides, man. And they do it on purpose. It's like, y'all know what y'all do to us. Y'all know how us fans feel about the Ravens, man. And they just, man, it's just wild. But I'm very, very glad, obviously glad that he made it. And I say they need to give him another raise. They need to give him another raise, like, because he deserves it. Anyway, team, keep it clean. I appreciate y'all. I will see you all later on when we talk about the game and the good, the bad, the highs, the lows, the ins, the outs, and everything in our post-game thoughts video later on today. I'll see y'all soon. Y'all stay up. Love you. We out.